Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. For those of you who are new, hi, my name is Jess, and yes, I'm in a very different spot of my house. I'm in our dining room, and I am currently transitioning into a office slash library, clearly, space for me, myself, and I. It's gonna be a long project, you guys, but I'm really excited. I put our sofa chair in here. You've seen this probably several times in my videos. This was actually in our room, but I thought it'd look cute here. Plus, I have somewhere to sit for this video, and it's comfy. But yes, so I know you didn't want to hear me ramble. We're just gonna go and dive straight into this book. This is The Lost Apothecary by Sarah Penner. And oh my God, like I'm looking at this through the camera and it's just so shiny and beautiful, you guys. Honestly, that's why I picked this up in the first place at Barnes & Noble. The cover got to me. Like, other than seeing this in Barnes & Noble, I had never heard about it. It was really new. I bought it the first week it came out, which was in March. March 2nd, 2021 is when this book came out, and I bought it for my birthday. So it was a gift to myself. And I'm so glad I got this, you guys. This was a very, 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 very fast-paced read, and I pretty much kind of had to control myself because I didn't want to not savor the moment, you guys, of this wonderful book. So I finished this a couple of days ago, and I thought, you know, why not make a YouTube book review about this? And I'm gonna try and keep it spoiler free as much as possible. But basically, this book is historical fiction. It's set in the 1790s and also present day, and it follows three main characters. We have Eliza, we have Nella, and we have Caroline. And Eliza and Nella, they're in the 1790s, so they know each other, and Caroline is the only one in present day. And just to kind of give you like a synopsis that's in the book, it says, hidden in the depths of 18th century London, a secret apothecary shop caters to an unusual kind of clientele. Women across the city whisper of a mysterious figure named Nella, who sells well-disguised poisons to use against the oppressive men in their lives. Nella's dark world is no place for her newest patron, a precocious 12-year-old girl named Eliza Fanning, but their unexpected bond sparks a string of consequences that echoes through the centuries. 200 years later, aspiring historian Caroline Parswell discovers an aged apothecary vial in the River Thames. As she is newly grappling with the searing betrayal of her husband's infidelity, a curious research project is exactly the distraction Caroline needs. But when she discovers a link between the vial and London's long unsolved apothecary murders, Caroline's unpinned presence soon collides with an explosive history, binding her fate to Nella's and Eliza's in a stunning twist that transcends the barriers of time. So that, lovely ladies and gentlemen, was the synopsis of The Lost Apothecary. And I was, you know, when I first read this in Barnes & Noble, I was like, whoa, like I've never really read anything like this. The only time I've ever read a book that was like past and present was A Discovery of Witches trilogy, and I really enjoyed it. And I actually enjoyed it in here. So as far as like character development slash world development or like plot development goes, this to me was more, I don't know, I would say character development, because the plot or the world building itself wasn't that crazy. I mean, it was very simple to me, so I always considered, you know, when I was reading this, like it's very character driven, and that's what I really loved. You know, you're supposed to love all three girls in the book. You're supposed to love what they're doing, and honestly, I did. I'm not really a world building person per se. I mean, I just haven't found a book yet that I'm like really enjoying that I love the world building and not the character development or like the character issues. And so I would say this is definitely character building. Now, I do have a couple of notes here about the book, and I'm kind of going to do it in three. So I'm going to say three positives and then three negatives, and then we're just going to kind of dive into them. So first things first, we're going to talk about three things that I actually loved about the book. So I know a lot of people are saying that they can't really distinguish the timelines apart other than when clearly the author writes it, that you're in the 1790s versus present day. But to be honest, like I could totally tell just because of the way that Eliza and Nella were talking. They were kind of talking in a very like old-fashioned way, and then obviously you have Caroline who, you know, talks normally just like us. So that was one way that I could tell. And then also, I mean, the way that Eliza and Nella would describe the world. It was different. It's all I'm gonna say. I don't wanna say too much spoilers. And then Caroline, you know, clearly they had cell phones, they had computers. I mean, there was a lot of varying differences, such as technology, that would obviously say, okay, this is present day. So that's one. I really like that. I enjoyed it. Two, so I really loved the intro to the book, especially Caroline's world or present day. So she obviously, the reason why she's connected to it, and I really, this isn't a spoiler, but clearly her husband cheated on her, and during their 10-year anniversary they were supposed to go to London. Well, she ended up going by herself, and this is like a 7-day trip. She goes by herself and she's kind of just like meandering along the River Thames, and this guy comes up to her, kind of a seller of sorts, and he's like, hey, like, I'm doing a tour in the River Thames, and it's kind of just one of those things where you go into the river, you see if you can find something old, something lost, something forgotten, and then it's yours to keep. Like, that's just it. So of course she goes, and she's kind of just lost, and she's kind of sad, and you know, she's just walking along the river, and it's very stinky, it's very like sewagey everywhere, and she ends up seeing something that glistens, and she wants, you know, she goes ahead, she picks it up, and it's a very, very small vial with kind of a bear etched on the glass. And she's like, okay, I wonder what this is. And she talks to the guy. The guy's like, oh, I don't know. And so that's kind of how her story starts. And she goes on this like historical quest of sorts, because you kind of find out that she had a bachelor's in history, and she always wanted to work in a library. She always wanted to do research. And so a part of her being there is like, well, maybe, you know, with my husband out of the picture right now, I can find myself. And so she embarks on this journey of figuring out what this vial is. So I really enjoyed that. That's kind of honestly what captured my attention. Not so much Nella and Eliza's intro. I mean, they were okay, but I just really enjoyed Caroline's part and the reason as to why she was trying to figure out, okay, what is this vial? Obviously, it's one of Nella's vials from the apothecary back in the 1790s. So that's the second thing. The third thing is I loved the chase to find history throughout Caroline's journey. And it kind of put Nella and Eliza's character into it. I know I just said this, and it kind of goes hand in hand with point number two, but there's a part towards the end of the book where it kind of reminded me of, I don't know, like a Nicolas Cage movie, like National Treasure, or it kind of reminded me of Discovery of Witches, like the last book, where you feel like you're under a time crunch trying to find solutions and trying to figure out, like, okay, what is this vial really like? Who is this apothecary owner? What are they exactly doing? Because Caroline, you know, she's starting to figure things out. She's putting two and two together, and she's under a time crunch essentially because something crazy happens, which is going to be on the negative side of my list. And it just makes her like, okay, like, what is this? What is this? What is this? And so she goes to a museum. She makes a friend there. It's just like a whole crazy embargo. And so that's kind of like the main reason why I kept reading this book. Now on to the negatives. So the first thing, and I'm not gonna spoil it, but Eliza is a 12-year-old girl, and of course, you know, this is the 1790s. You have to remember that, you know, women didn't really talk too much about like sexual things and what happens to a woman's body, and like, you know, what happens when you're like 13 or 14, like, why is a man looking at you? And this kind of happens to Eliza, where she basically gets her period and she has no clue. It turns out that the lady of the house wants to poison her husband, and Eliza thinks that when the guy dies that his spirit is haunting her, and that's why she is bleeding. And you basically go through the whole book with her really believing that a spirit is causing her to bleed, and she thinks that if she creates some type of magical potion that he's going to leave her body and she's going to stop bleeding. Now that would have been okay if she would have found out towards the very, very beginning of the book from Nella or from another woman figure in the book that no, this is actually your period. And it was kind of hard for me to believe that she had no clue what a period even was, and like that her body was changing because she was having cramps, she wasn't feeling great. And so you go through the whole story and I just couldn't find it believable. And it was kind of just annoying at certain parts. And even at the very beginning, it basically leads up to this like weird ending, and I just couldn't believe it. So that's the first thing. The second thing, so Caroline's husband is, without saying spoilers, just his personality, he's very predictable. He's kind of like a flat character, you know, he only has like one or two personality traits. And towards the end of the book, he does something that is so ridiculous, that goes against his character, that I'm just like, what in the world is happening? And again, it kind of takes me out of the book because it's just like, not, I mean, obviously he's not a main character, but like going with what the author has written him as, like, it's hard to believe. Like, are you seriously saying that what he did is what, you know, his personality? It's just like so crazy, you guys. I really wish I could say it, but I'm not gonna have any spoilers in this video. But he just does something like bat crazy wild, and it's hard to believe. And it's one of the like plot twist basically that I'm just not enjoying, and kind of took me out of the book. So I was going to rate this book like a 4, but because of him, I think I rated it a 3 on Goodreads. So maybe I should change it. Maybe I should put like a 3.5. I don't know. But that was the second thing. The third thing is that I felt like the book was too short and it needed more detail, because towards the end, it just felt too cramped. It felt like, you know, she used 300 pages to basically la-di-da around in this book. And then like the last 20, she had to jam every single plot twist, every single detail. And I just kind of had to take a moment at certain parts to be like, whoa, 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 wait, what is happening? And I had to reread certain parts. I had to go back to the beginning to like just verify what was actually happening. And I felt like, I mean, 320 pages is a lot, but I think that this book needed like an extra 40 to 60 pages. That way it just didn't feel all crammed. Plus the ending, I'm not gonna lie, I did not like the ending. It didn't make sense to me with what was happening in the beginning and middle of the book. And I felt like she just didn't realize how to end the book. And so she wrote it in a way that just kind of made sense, but it really didn't. Like when you actually stop to think about it and you stop to think about how the characters were the entirety of the book, and then you realize like, wait, that doesn't make any sense. Like they're not lining up to how she wrote them in the beginning. So yeah, so those are my positives and negatives. I mean, overall, you guys, I know I was kind of very negative towards the end. I mean, the book is like a average 3.5 book, or that's what I would consider it. I mean, there were beautiful parts in it. I did, like I said, like the past, the present, I liked how those timelines lined up. And to me personally, what helped as well is you wouldn't see like the same scenario but in different eyes. I hate when that happens, where you go from one character and they explain the scene, and then you go to another one and they explain the same scene just in their point of view. I hate that, and I honestly didn't get that in this book, so I was kind of grateful for that. And then kind of just, you know, like I said, the chase for history. I've always loved that in books, especially A Discovery of Witches is when I first kind of fell in love with that type of book read, and I really enjoyed it. So overall, I think it's a 3.5. I do highly recommend it. It is a fast-paced read. I think if you have a reading slump, this is a great book to kind of get you out of it. And if you love plot twists that are kind of unbelievable, then I think this book is for you. I mean, I wouldn't reread this book again, but there's probably someone out there who really enjoys it. And honestly, I think this book is very, very popular, because when I went to my local bookstore, they had a crap ton of this book on their shelves. And they had like a little note, because I went to Book People And they had a little note from one of the workers there, and it was like, this is very popular, like we always have to kind of order this book. Goodreads has it rated really well. I've now on BookTube, everyone is talking about it, but I think that's just because it's so new. It came out this month. So anyways, you guys, I really hope that you enjoyed this book review. I'm gonna be doing more, so expect that in the future. I had a huge book haul pretty much for my birthday and got a lot of great books. So without further ado, you guys, I hope you have a lovely day wherever you are in the world. Bye. Come on, children of